HCN Evening News Bulletin with me, Clarissa Camillo. Let's take a look at the top stories for today. On Sunday, in a shocking incident, minor siblings were sexually abused by a ward boy of the district hospital inside the lift. Mapsa police has arrested the accused.
On Sunday, the incident happened when a ward boy of the district hospital inside the lift assaulted and sexually abused two minor girls. Here are the highlights. The ward boy is identified as Govind. He has been arrested by the Mapsa police under section 354, 354A, 354D, IPC, section 8 of the Goa Children's Act, section 8, section 10 of the POSCO Act. As per sources, the said ward boy took advantage of the situation inside the hospital lift. According to the police, the said ward boy took advantage of the situation inside the hospital lift to contact complainants' minor sisters at the age of 17 years and 13 years to foster personal interaction despite a clear indication by them. The ward boy touched them up inappropriately without their wish and consent, while shifting their injured mother for treatment, thereby outraging the mendacity of the complainants' minor sisters and attempt to contact them by calling on the mobile phone.
MV Cordelia Empress arrives to Ampati on Sunday. This is the first cruise ship to arrive in the cruise tourism season after the pandemic. The vessel got in around 1,500 passengers and 600 crew members on maiden visit. The said vessel is set to make 58 calls to Goa.
एक आफ्टर पेंडेमिक जे आता चालू असले 2020 आम्ही मार्चान लास्ट बोट अटेंड केली त्याच्या उपरांत कांयच क्रूज सिजनूच नसलो आणि लोकांचे खूप प्रॉब्लम झालो की हांगा कांयच बिझनसूय नसलो पण होप जालो की गोवा इंडियन गव्हर्मेंट आणि सगळ्यांनी जी कितें हेल्प करून ही एक क्रूज लायन कोस्टल क्रूज लायन सुरू झाली ही बॉम्बेच्यान सुरू झाले बॉम्बे तेंच्यांनी 2-3 कॉल्स केल्या बॉम्बे टू कोचीन मागीर लक्षद्वीप केल्या आतां हांगा येयल्या बॉम्बेच्या आणि गोयात तिचे अबाउट 58 कॉल्स आहात कंटिन्युअसली आणि आता बरीच एक गजल म्हणजे 1,591 पॅसेंजर्स असतात आणि क्रू अबाउट 600 असतात क्रूज इज टेकिंग अप म्हणजे हो नंबर वाढत वतलो जे मार्केट ट्रेन वयता ते पण दिसता की हे वाढत वयतले आणि आता पळयात की अजून फुल्ली SOP भितर रिलॅक्सेशन जावं ना त्या खातीर सगळे पॅसेंजर देंवतले काय ना ते हे ना आणि मोस्टली फर्स्ट कॉल असा ते मोस्टली प्रोमोशनल कॉल असा त्या खातीर पॅसेंजर देंवतलेच अशें काय अजून ना जे पर्यंत शिपार चढना तो पर्यंत आमकां काय कळचें ना शिपार चढल्या उपरांत आमकां सगळे डिटेल कळतले आणि दे आर ऑल्सो हॅप्पी परत 1 तारखेक हांगाच्यान बोटीचेर व्हडलो इव्हेंट जावपाचो इट इज लायक व्हडलो म्युझिकल शो जावपाचो त्याच्या खातीर भरपूर इक्विपमेंट्स बी सगळे येवपाचे सो फस्टाच्यान तेंचे फूल गियरअप जातले आणि पॅसेंजरूय वाढपाची शक्यता आणि त्यांना पॅसेंजरूय देंवतले आता प्रेझेंटली तितले काय पॅसेंजर देंवपाचे असे काय ना एकूच टूर ऑपरेटर कोण तरी तेंच्यांनी अपॉइंट केला 50 पॅसेंजर कन्फर्म झाले की ते देंवतले म्हणून म्हणजे भोंवपाक गोवा आणि अबाउट 75 पॅसेंजर हांगा आता जॉईन जावपाचे आताच खबर येयले आणि हेतून हे क्रूज येयल्या त्या खातीर हे सगळे पोर्टानूय बिझनस सुरू झाला हांगाय कितें गोंयकारांकूय आमकां कितें तरी बिझनस मेळटलो
For information, we got about 1,500 passengers are there and 500 crews.
Okay.
This is the first cruise of the season. As you all are aware that after COVID, cruise industry has been totally affected. Now, we hope so after this one, following the complete protocol, we ensure that cruise service will be streamlined. And now it has come to Goa, again go back to Goa. The first call is 1,500, it's a very good sight. Hope so it will improve. Got a good chance.
Sir, will there be an exchange of plaque because the vessel is come for the first
time? Yeah. This is our normal practice. Every new cruise comes, we exchange the plaque. Okay.
How advantageous is this cruise vessel for the Murmugam port considering the business part of it, sir?
See, as you aware that the cruise business itself is the Government of India's premier project. For that, boat has already slashed the rates and we are developing an international cruise terminal also at 100 crore rupees. As per as a cargo ship, cargo port, cruise business may not be very lucrative. Still, as a social responsibility, we are doing it. It is good for the region. It is good for Goa.
First of all, it's the brightest day for us. Government has put a lot of protocols in place. Port is also following a lot of protocols. So it's a very, a lot of checks in place for tourists who are coming in, and from the ship going out to Goa, all those checks are being maintained, certification for RT-PCR, everything is checked. And it's good for Goa, more tourists coming, we'll have more revenue generated. And also to give an idea to the people that everything is safe and sound in Goa with all the checks that have been laid down by Government of India, that is RT-PCR test, double vaccinated. So it's a very bright day for all associated with this kind of trade, that is bus owners, taxi owners, restaurants, shopping, everyone. It's good for Goa, and for us it's fantastic. We have 58 calls of this beautiful vessel calling ports of Goa, and hope to look it's successful, so that we also, everyone around associated with this business, are also successful. Thank you so much.
Recently, the world celebrated the International Coastal Cleanup Day 2021. And on this day, the students of Goa University conducted a cleanliness drive at the Miramar Beach with an aim to keep the beaches and the surroundings clean.
I am Professor Rivankar, Dean of School of Earth, Ocean and Atmospheric Sciences, Goa University. This is an international beach clean drive wherein Government of India has selected 35 beaches all over India, and Goa University School of Earth, Ocean and Atmospheric Sciences has selected Miramar University, Miramar Beach as one of the sites for beach clean drive. So there are about 100 students and about 21 faculty members who have participated along with our estate division to clean this, and we have cleaned this for about a distance of about 1 kilometer on either sides, and we are going to take this waste also to university where we have our garbage treatment and all that.
Okay, basically what was the idea of cleaning this?
This is Government of India initiative to clean beaches which have become dirty under Ministry of Earth Sciences in view of the marine litter and marine debris that is being creating a havoc as far as marine life is concerned. So in view of that, they have programmed to clean all over India. So Goa, they have selected two beaches. One is Miramar, another is Karanjalam, which will be done by National Institute of Oceanography.
Okay, so when did you start this?
We started around 2 o'clock, and it is almost now getting over, maybe by 6 o'clock.
So what type of waste basically you got?
We got maximum of plastic and nylon net waste, which is understood to be a major source of marine litter in the world oceans. So all over globe, this has become a major issue. Not only Goa, but other places also you find such type of waste that is being generated. And Goa being tourism oriented, we have a lot of such type of waste that is generated.
I'm Dr. Sangeeta Naik of School of Earth, Ocean, Atmospheric Sciences. So we had organized one coastal cleanup drive, which is an international coastal cleanup drive. So across the country, both on the west coast of India and east coast of India, this cleanliness drive is going on. Because this month, on 18th of September, we had this international coastal cleanup drive. So in association with other institutes, we are carrying out this task. So we have so far, here you can see some of this trash which we have collected. Still we are segregating and weighing it. So exact count or number or weight exactly right now I cannot tell you, because we are still segregating it, but we'll update you.
Okay,
yes.
So what type of waste basically you got?
Majorly ropes, plastic, less of metal, glass, and all other things were here.
So how dangerous is this for the environment?
It's, if any of the marine organisms or, get most of these debris which are on the shore now were part of the ocean, okay, because somewhere they were dumped and now they have come over here, most of them. Some of them were dumped by the tourists who come over here. So what happens, these ropes and these trashes, organisms cannot differentiate between them, okay. So some of the organisms can get entangled between them. You may have seen some organisms like turtles and all are stranded with these ropes. So this happens. Also, what happens with time, this plastic, they get segregated into, they get broken down into smaller microplastic. And this has contributed a major, you know, this has become a major menace throughout the world. Not only here, but throughout the world. We have this gigantic jars of plastics across in the major world oceans. So this drives only to ensure to clean the beaches and spread the awareness among the locals, students also, so that they understand this responsibility of cleaning is of not only the students or us, but each one of us, all the citizens of the country or across the globe. They should be aware that whatever we throw finally reaches the ocean and it impacts each one of us, not only marine organism, but finally it reaches us. Another thing I would like to add was these microplastics which gets into the ocean. They get into the fishes because they will be consumed by them for the smaller organism. Then eventually it reaches our platter also. So yeah, we have to take.
My name is Ankur Saini. I'm a part one student in marine science. So this was our first trip. We were told that we are on 24th September. There is a cleanup, beach cleanup day on the International Coastal Cleanup Day. They are organizing a beach cleanup day at Miramar Beach. So we were, as the marine science department, it was our responsibility to come here and to clean the beaches. And it was really a nice experience cleaning the beach. Now we are also like satisfied seeing the clean beach. And we collected different kinds of waste here, plastic waste, glass bottles, straws, spoons, wooden waste, and most of the waste was of like devotional things, like because recently the Ganesh Chaturthi was happened, so most of the waste was of that. And now we are segregating and we'll weigh them, and we'll classify that what amount of waste for different strata we got.
I am in part of the student of applied geology. I am from Kerala. Now I am studying here like 2 years. And when we come here, it is full of pollutant. So if we clean it, we can use it as a ground or something for children. But now it is full of plastic waste, glass bottle, and many waste from Ganesh Chaturthi and all.
Okay, so how dangerous is this for the environment?
It is dangerous for marine organisms, and it will not degrade because it is plastic. So it is very dangerous for soil also.
On Sunday, a tourist rental cab was spotted on the beach in North Goa. A group of young tourists were spotted driving the rent vehicle on the beach, which caused a lot of inconvenience to the visitors and children playing on the beach. And here is the roundup of the top stories of the week.
Puti Gaonkar of the Mining Dependence Forum has announced the formation of the Mining Dependence Forum, which will field candidates for ensuring assembly polls and work against the BJP in several constituencies. He also added that he will contest against the Chief Minister, Dr. Pramod Sawant, from his own constituency, Sanklim constituency, only
if it is a straight fight.
या राज्य दोन लोक पद्धतीचे लोकांचं चाललं. पहिलेचे लोक जे खरंच कार्य करून समाज कार्य करून दिलेले त्यांच्यानी चाललेले आणि आज जे राज्य चाललं ते सगळे राज हे कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर कोणी काढत हे मायनिंग कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर जे असतात आता ते आज राज्य चालवतात. आणि तुम्ही एक हिस्ट्री काढून पहा 1985 पासूनची हिस्ट्री जर सुद्धा घेतली 2005 पर्यंत जे मायनिंग चलताले ते मायनिंगचं रेट $30 $25 $24 असं त्या डॉलरचे चलता त्यांना खूप चोरीयो करप्शन म्हणजे माल चोरून धरून विकप इलिगल ॲक्टिव्हिटीज करप हे पहिली त्यांनाच जमत ज्यांना हे कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर भीतर चालले जे आज राज्य सत्तेत असत त्या कॉन्ट्रॅक्टरांनी हांगा करप्शन सुरू केले आणि आज तेच लोक SIT केल्या म्हणतात रिपोर्ट येणार निवडून दुसऱ्या जाग्याचेर येतात दुसरे पार्टीत निवडून येतात आणि मागेर सरकार त्यांना सांगता तुम्ही जर हे पार्टी रोलिंग पार्टी जर जॉईन जाऊ नका जाल्यार तुमचे केसी फायल करतले आणि तुमचे जे किती कॅरियर असतात आम्ही स्टॉप करतले म्हणून त्यांना भिवून धमकी देऊन पैसे देऊन त्यांना गव्हर्नमेंट फॉर्म केले गेले. आज हे गव्हर्नमेंट जर गोयचे जर बरे गव्हर्नमेंट जाय जाल्यार बरे कॅन्डिडेट BJP जे आज अंधाधुंद कारभार चालला तो जर स्टॉप जावपाक जाय क्लीन गव्हर्नमेंट जर जावपाक जाय नॉन करप्ट गव्हर्नमेंट जर जावपाक जाय जाल्यार म्हाका दिसता की लायक मायंडेड जे लोक आसात ते सगळ्यांनी एकत्र येवन ज्या ज्या जाग्यार जे जे विनींग कॅन्डिडेट आसा त्या विनींग कॅन्डिडेटांक एकामेका लोकांनी सपोर्ट करून ते BJP जो कॅन्डिडेट आसात BJP जे सत्ताधारी लोक आसात त्यांना नेस्ताबूत करपाची आज ऑपॉर्च्युनिटी आसा. आज जनमानसात एक राग असा की ह्यांना आम्ही निवडून दिले आणि ह्यांच्यानी कायच करू ना फक्त आपली पोटा भरली असं एक राग असा आणि लोकांक आज परिवर्तन जाय. तुम्ही एक लक्षात घ्या आज आप गोवा रेव्होल्युशनरी काँग्रेसचे काही नवीन सिस्टम त्यांनी इंट्रोड्यूस केल्या कारणान आणि MGP असे चार प्रॉमिनंट ग्रुप म्हणजे पार्टीज हांगा काम करतात एक लोक हे काम करतात आणि त्यांच्यानी गोय टिकोवपा खातीर पार्टिक्युलरली RG जे असतात आपाचे एक धोरण वेगळे करून ते असतात आणि ते आज हांगा इलेक्शन लढोवपाची तयारी आसा. म्हाका सगळ्यांक रिक्वेस्ट करपाचे आहा तेंका सगळ्यांक मायनींग सायडीन हे फावटी आज आम्ही हांगा डिक्लेअर करतात इंडिपेंडंट फोरम हो आम्ही फॉर्म करतले म्हणजे आज तो डिक्लेरेशन आज जाल्ले आसात आणि ह्या फोरमाच्या अंडर मायनींग डिपेंड जो एरिया आसात विशेक जो असेंब्ली सेगमेंट आसा थंय BJP अगेन्स्ट आम्ही आमचे कॅन्डिडेट दवरले एक फ्रंट करून दवरले आणि ज्यो बाकीच्यो पार्टी आसात त्यो पार्टीक आम्ही रिक्वेस्ट करतले की ज्या ज्या जाग्यार आमचे कॅन्डिडेट स्ट्रॉंग आसा आमचे कॅन्डिडेट मायनींग आमचे डिपेंडंट लोक निवडून दितले त्यांना तुम्ही सपोर्ट करा तुम्ही ज्या जाग्यार स्ट्रॉंग आसात थंय आम्ही तुमकां सपोर्ट करतले आणि BJP जे सरकार आसा BJP जे प्रेझेंट गव्हर्नमेंट आसा त्याका आम्ही परत धाडपाची गरज आसा कारण तुमकां लक्षात येतले मी परत येईन हो एक स्लोगन तुम्ही महाराष्ट्रात ऐकला आज महाराष्ट्रात गोयात असो स्लोगन दिवपी येयला पण त्याका आम्ही स्लोगन प्रती दिवपाचे आसात की मी परत जाईन हो त्याका स्लोगन आसा गोयच्या.
Decision on restarting the schools will be taken shortly after a special meeting is held with the task force. The Chief Minister Dr. Pramod Sawant also said that charter tourism and flights will resume soon as his government as well as himself is following up with the center on this issue. Watch.
TTEG ची रिक्वेस्ट घेऊन आम्ही बी केंद्र सरकारक बरेला की चार्टर फ्लाइट अलाउ करचे म्हणून वी आर वेटिंग फॉर देअर परमिशन.
The Trinamool Congress leader Derek O'Brien on Saturday said that his party would be contesting the next year's Goa Assembly post. The party will announce its chief ministerial candidate soon, he added. We are here as a serious contenders against the BJP, the ruling. Mamata Banerjee-led party has no high command culture and will pick credible local leaders in the coastal state. Since arriving in Goa from Friday onwards, Derek O'Brien has met representatives of the civil society as well as political leaders. Here are the highlights.
TMC General Secretary Derek O'Brien said the TMC is serious in contesting the ensuing Goa Assembly polls. TMC will contest 2022 Goa Assembly polls and Tripura Assembly polls, which are due in 2023. We have done a good groundwork, and TMC is the party which will work with the action team and agency. Our agency is in Goa since mid-July and has extensive research. We have a real picture of Goa. We have a 5-year contract with the IPAC agency, whose 180 people are currently in Goa. We have been in talkings to several civic society members and politicians. Derek himself will be camping in Goa till run-up to the Goa polls. Expect attending parliament sessions. Also, 3 to 4 TMC MPs will join the Goa election campaign. Electorate of Goa are angry on both the national parties, example, the BJP and the Congress. We will soon have the credible leader as parties face for the election, as would feel fresh faces. TMC policy is one of the man policy. TMC will have no pre-poll alliance with any political party. Watch.
Indian Meteorological Center in its forecast has said that Goa will witness heavy rainfall of 6.4 centimeters from Monday onwards. The increase in rainfall activity is because of the low pressure area formed over Bay of Bengal, which has intensified further into deep depression and lay centered over northwest and adjoining West Central Bay of Bengal.
नमस्कार 25th सितंबर के 8:30 AM को जो पास्ट 24 आवर्स के लिए रेनफॉल रिपोर्ट हुआ उसमें सिग्निफिकेंट रेनफॉल जो भी रेनफॉल हुआ दो जगह पे लाइट रेनफॉल ही हुआ है और हाईएस्ट रेनफॉल था सिर्फ 3 मिलीमीटर्स ऑफ रेनफॉल जो वालपोई में रिपोर्ट हुआ और आज की डेट में अगर सीजन का इस मानसून सीजन का क्यूमुलेटिव स्टेट एवरेज रेनफॉल हम देखेंगे तो दैट इज 5% higher than normal. Normal value है around 29 centimeters. तो हमें अभी तक cumulative around 30 centimeters of rainfall मिला है 30 centimeters. तो 5 centimeters higher than normal है. और season end होने के लिए season का rainfall calculation end होने के लिए around 5 more days are there. And we are expecting the activity of rainfall to continue. Normal or higher than normal values for this remaining 4 to 5 days also. So if we discuss about the main weather system that is prevailing as on today, ये forecast किया गया था कि 24th के आसपास और एक low pressure area बनने वाला है Bay of Bengal में. तो yesterday 24th को वो low pressure बना और उसका further intensification हुआ depression और deep depression के stage में है वो अभी और it is expected to become a cyclone in next 6 hours Bay of Bengal ke upar ek cyclone banne ka possibility hai aane wale 6 hours mein aur jaise hi wo cyclone banega aur uska already uska movement hai westward direction mein aur jaise wo cyclone ban jayega to further uska westward movement hone ke chances hain aur uska landfall nahi to cross it will cross between North Andhra Pradesh and South Odisha coast in the evening of 26th. कल 26th के evening hours को ये cyclone North Andhra Pradesh और South Odisha के बीच में से near around Kalingapatnam वो cross होने के chances हैं. तो ये जो system है उसका severe effect obviously Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Chhattisgarh और सम पार्ट्स ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल यहाँ पे होने वाला है वो जगह पे वो स्टेट्स में हेवी रेनफॉल और सीवियर रेनफॉल और सीवियर विंड स्पीड सब होने के चांसेस है लेकिन ये सिस्टम जैसे लैंडफॉल होगा उसके आफ्टरवर्ड्स इट्स लैंडफॉल आल्सो द सिस्टम इज गोइंग टू मूव दो इट्स इंटेंसिटी में डिक्रीज बट इट इज गोइंग टू मूव स्टिल वेस्टवर्ड नॉर्थ वेस्टवर्ड डायरेक्शन तो फ्रॉम अराउंड 26th गोवा के ऊपर भी यानी कि कल 26th में भी फ्रॉम अराउंड इवनिंग और लेट इवनिंग आल्सो रेनफॉल ओवर गोवा आल्सो इज लाइकली टू इंक्रीज द क्लाउडिंग एंड रेनफॉल एक्टिविटी में इंक्रीज देन व्हाट इट इज for the past 24 or 48 hours. From 27th, we are expecting heavy rainfall, that is rainfall exceeding 6.4 centimeters in 24 hours. So that heavy rainfall is expected at one or two places over both the districts of Goa on 27th, 28th and 29th of September. And even in these days, other days such as 26th and 25th also, we will have light to moderate rainfall, even though the distribution may be less on 25th. Light to moderate rainfall or thunder showers will be there on 25th, but maybe fairly widespread distribution. On 26th onwards, the distribution also will increase. And from 27th, we are expecting heavy rainfall at isolated places. Now, on 27th and 28th, there is possibility that the wind speeds also may be around 30 or 40 kilometers per hour over Goa. It's not any destructive wind speed. But please be regularly updated with the warnings that IMD is issuing in these coming days, because the rainfall activity, wind speed, all this will depend on the intensity and location of the system that we were discussing while it is moving through the inland area.
Well, that's all we have in today's news bulletin. For more news and updates, please do subscribe to our YouTube channel at HCN Goa. Stay alerted by following us on Twitter and Facebook at Overaldo. Until then, goodbye and take care.